Hello, my name is Anna Dietz. I'm a member of the European Parliament from the Social Democratic Group. I'm here today in the studio of John Dündar. Thank you so much for having me here.
I thank you for coming.
Well, I'm actually bringing news. I'm bringing news because I have been just in Istanbul, and I'm bringing news here from the Cumhuriyet trial. This has been the newspaper of the day the trial started.
That's perfect. I mean, not bringing only news, but newspapers as well.
Well, sure. This is because it's your newspaper as well. You have been the chief editor, and you are actually here on the trial.
Exactly.
Which is kind of weird. But it's so good that you're here, that they cannot take hostage on you. And so I bring the paper, at least, that you see.
Thank you very much. And thank you for going there and getting, you know, this solidarity was so important, and we appreciate.
Well, this is the latest thing, the last thing I can do. And you spoke so well, and you have been with us also in the party congress from the SPD,
yeah,
which was important to us. And we had only a few standing ovations, and one was for the civil society media in Turkey. Yeah. So, you know, it matters to us, and we need the solidarity. The half of the population didn't vote for the referendum of Erdogan.
Exactly.
And so we stand on the side, on the positive, pro-democratic, pro-EU side of the European,
thank you very much,
Turkish population.
And so, yeah, unfortunately, there's a misunderstanding in Germany. Many people, you know, see Turkey as equal to Erdogan, which is not true.
Absolutely.
So there's another Turkey struggling, suffering at the moment, and struggling for democracy in Turkey. So we are happy that you are standing behind us and struggling with us.
Well, that's for sure. I was there together with a colleague, Rebecca Harms from Bündnis 90 Die Grüne, and we both showed solidarity also for the European Parliament, trying and pushing for getting people out of the prison. That's not only Turkish people in the prisons, but also Europeans. We have two
Germans.
We have two Germans. One is called Peter Steutner. He just got the weekend before I moved there and had conversations. He's now in the prison. And
also, in solitary confinement.
Yeah, and also Dennis Yücel is there as well. So two Germans. So it's also, you know, we fighting for all people who are in Turkey active, and there's no law and no justice anymore.
And Erdogan is not only our problem now.
Right.
So it's an international problem.
Right, but lucky us, we are in the same system of values because we both joined the NATO. And so let's call him up on that he's joining our values. And so... Now, if you see that, I've been there, it was a chaotic situation, but what I saw, very strong speaking journalists, not getting the accusation really on their face, but actually arguing that they have written about the main question, if they have been part of the terror movements or not, that they have written about it, actually, to warn about them, because they would harm democracy. How do you perceive the court now being here? I mean, you are one of the people being actually on court there. And also, how have you perceived the last day of the court?
Well, imagine yourself just defending yourself in a courtroom where, under the control of the government, you know that. And everything you say can endanger your freedom in the coming future. But those people still standing, you know, defending their values courageously, and saying what they have to say. So really, after 9 months in prison, I admire their courage and their struggle, and they are so powerful guys, and I'm proud of them. And this paper is still, you know, still struggling, and it is really important. I'm trying to be their, you know, correspondent in Europe and trying to give them a voice in every language from here, from this studio. And it's strange that for the first time in my life, I'm doing my defense from here, from Berlin. So it's weird, but it's the reality.
Right. I sent greetings because I met you the day before here at this demonstration. I talked about that you are in solidarity with the people over there, but also with your colleagues. And what is very important, as you just mentioned, Özgürüz is a magazine.
Yeah.
You have been created here. So talk a little bit about it. What is it about and what do you do in it?
Well, we are doing in the studio some news, of course, every daily news, but it's, you know, it's over just after an hour, it's old. But we need something more deeper to understand what's going on in Turkey. So we decided to publish this magazine, which contains analysis on Turkey, deep, some interviews, some deep research, etc. So it's important to It is in German and Turkish, and it's important for both countries to understand each other. So the other way around is Turkish.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Exactly. So we published 10 very important investigations on Turkey.
Right.
So it will be one in two months in the beginning, then it will be monthly. And I hope Germans as well can have it and learn what's going on in Turkey better.
Absolutely. So to everyone who's interested, they can buy it in the stores?
Yeah, hopefully they will. But for the moment, we have a society, and if they can send us a mail, we can directly send them free.
Right. So please check them out. They are also online. They have Twitter accounts. You do all social media.
Yeah, Özgürüz.org. Yeah.
Right. So you can just look it up, and you're easily approachable.
Exactly. And then we can just send it free.
Right. So thank you so much for doing this work and giving also importance, because we had a letter being sent by Sigmar Gabriel, being published towards the people from Turkey living in Germany, matter if they have a citizenship or not, because it's so important, because we have nearly 3 million people here also living in Germany. And so we need open discussion, and we need to talk about what is happening, and we need debates, but not a one-sided debate. So thank you so much for your work. All the best for you and your team. And we will also look out for you and visit you again
hopefully
in the future.
Next time, hopefully, we'll be going together. And thank you for your support and solidarity.
Sure. All the best.